The next property you write down, electronegativity. What about electronegativity? We know as we go down the group, electronegativity decreases. Write down, as we go down the group, electronegativity decreases. There is no exceptions into this. Okay. Write down next, melting point and boiling point. Melting point and boiling point. Write down into this. The melting point of the elements of group 15 increases from nitrogen to arsenic and then decreases. The melting point of the elements of group 15 first increases from nitrogen to arsenic and then decreases to antimony and bismuth. Okay, the overall order is this. For melting point, the overall, or it is not a regular trend. So obviously this you have to memorize. Nitrogen is minimum and then phosphorus, bismuth, then antimony and arsenic. Yes, arsenic. The reason behind this you write down. As the atomic size increases, as the atomic size increases, melting point increases. The decrease in melting point. The decrease in melting point of antimony and bismuth is because of inert pair effect. Due to inert pair effect, these elements, means antimony and bismuth, has tendency to form 3 covalent bond instead of 5 covalent bond. 3 covalent bond instead of 5 covalent bond. Okay, and we know what? Number of covalent bond increases, melting point increases. Okay, so in the case of antimony and bismuth, inert pair effect is applied there, right? What is inert pair effect? You see, if I write down, suppose this outermost electronic configuration, suppose we have 4s2 and 4p3, or suppose I am taking 5s2 5p3. So inertial electrons, you see here in 4s2 4p3 and 5s2 5p3, the inner shell, wait, I will take here 6 and 6. Okay, because 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, correct. So we'll take 6 and 5. Write again. 6s2 6p3. Now the inner shell electron, you see 6s2 6p3. Before this, there is 3d and 4d electrons, right? It means basically d and f orbitals present in the inner shell in the both molecule. You see d and f subshell shows weak screening effect. Write down, d and f subshell shows weak screening effect. Now, because of weak screening effect, these electrons, the two electron which is present in the s subshell of the outermost shell, which is this s subshell of the outermost shell, these electrons are strongly attracted towards the nucleus, because this shows weak screening effect and this is strongly bonded towards the nucleus, and that is why the tendency for these electrons to take part in the reaction is very less. Okay, and that is also possible, but you have to provide very high amount of energy then. Okay, for these electrons to take part in reaction, it requires very high amount of energy, because it is strongly bounded with the nucleus. Okay, so that is why we say, because of weak screening effect of d and f subshell, these two electrons are inert towards the bonding, and this is nothing but the inert pair effect. Inert and a pair of electron, so inert pair effect. That's why the elements which is there in the bottom of the any group, those elements shows this kind of effect, because for this we required weak screening effect, right? That is only possible with d and f orbital, which is there in the lower elements of any group. That's why, because of weak screening effect, these two electrons are strongly bounded, won't have any tendency to take part in the reaction. So only these three electrons will take part in the bonding, not reaction. That's why they forms only three covalent bond. And number of covalent bond increases, so melting point increases. That is why bismuth and antimony has lesser melting point than expected value. Okay. Another one, the boiling point.
Only one that disconnect out.
The boiling point.
Was clear idea. Clear.
The boiling point order is minimum for phosphorus, then nitrogen, arsenic.
Very good. Distract.
Okay, this is the order of boiling point. You see, it is also a regular trend. You must remember this. Okay, the reason of this, you write down. As we go down the group, boiling point increases due to increase in atomic size. For phosphorus, for this trend, phosphorus and nitrogen, this is an exception. Okay. After this, it is the regular trend view. So this is an exception view. You must remember this. The boiling point of phosphorus is lesser than to that of nitrogen. Exception. Okay. Next one. Metallic character. What is the metallic nature? The metals are what? Metals are have tendency to lose electrons. Okay. So metals have tendency to lose electrons. So what we can say, as the tendency to lose electron increases, metallic nature increases. Correct. So down the group, if you are going, then ionization energy decreases. Why? Because the size is increasing. Okay. So ionization energy decreases. It means the tendency to lose electron is more. Right. That's why down the group, metallic nature also increases. Write down this point. As we go down the group, ionization energy decreases, hence tendency to lose electron is more, metallic nature increases. Okay. the elements we have nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, and bismuth. So in all these five elements, these two, the first two are non-metals. Their property is close to non-metals. These two are metalloids. Semi-metal also we call it as metalloids. Bismuth has very weak ionization energy, behaves as a metal. Okay, next you write down oxidation state. Oxidation state. So in the outermost shell, these elements has five electrons. Okay, general outermost electronic configuration is what? It is NS2 NP3. Okay. So from here only we discuss this oxidation state. There are two possibilities to gain octet or stable state configuration. One is what? It can accept three electrons. So 5+3 becomes 8. Or another thing is what? It can lose this 5 electron. Okay. So when it loses 5 electron, the oxidation state is what? +5. Okay. And when it gains 3 electron to gain octet, oxidation state it is -3. So range of the oxidation state is what? It can be anything from -3 to +5. That is one thing. -3 to +5. Okay. Now, if you talk about the stability of +5 oxidation state, as we go down the group, okay, we know because of inert pair of effect, here only we have discussed that these two electrons are what? These two electrons are inert towards bonding. Okay. That's why the tendency to form +5 oxidation state as we go down the group increases or decreases? Decreases, right? Write down the tendency to form +5 oxidation state down the group as we go down the group decreases. Reason is same, inert pair effect. And tendency to form, next line, +3 oxidation state increases as we go down the group. See, -3 and +5 are the two extremes actually. All these, that's what I'm discussing now. -3 and +5 are two extreme conditions. -3 when possible, when it accepts 3 electrons. +5 when it loses 5 electrons. Okay. So both conditions are extreme. So all these elements always has a tendency to gain the intermediate oxidation state, right? That is the most stable state we have. So generally you see nitrogen forms what? NH3, PS3 kind of molecule forms. Where the oxidation state of nitrogen is what? +3 or phosphorus is also +3. So these two are the extreme condition we have. +5 and -3 are the extreme condition, okay? But intermediate of these two is around +3 or +4 also sometimes possible, okay? +2 also possible. So generally these elements exist in a state where the oxidation state is mainly +3, +2 or +4 like that. Okay. +5 and -3, it is very unstable oxidation state, right? So what we can say, +5 oxidation state decreases down the group tendency to form, but that of +3 increases as we go down the group. Okay. One more point to write down into this. Nitrogen, one exception we have here, nitrogen never shows pentavalency due to its small size small size and absence of d orbital. For nitrogen, plus 5 is not possible. Okay, it never forms NCl5 kind of compound. Okay, that is one thing you must remember. -3, next point, -3 oxidation state of nitrogen is because of its high electronegativity and small size. Example, we have NH3. Okay. Next, you write down the other property we have, that is atomicity. See, actually in this chapter, these property only we have to understand. There are some logic and exceptions. We can relate and then we can understand this. After this, if you have preparation of nitrogen and all that, you have to memorize. There you don't have to understand anything. Okay. Properties, exceptions, you know, oxides, hydrides, halides, whatever it forms. For there, you know, the trends like thermal stability and other things also you have to understand. But as far as the preparation is concerned, you have to memorize that, right? There you don't have to do anything into it.